Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Frenchie by Chelsea Elizabeth. Here on this channel we're all about sophisticated style and self-care. Today though I'm actually talking about study because so many of you guys ask me about the University of Melbourne. I studied there for 5 years in total, so I'm a bit of an expert when it comes to Uni Melb. So stay tuned for today's conversation. But first, could I ask you to help me out with two things? Please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, click that subscribe button, come and join the Frenchie fam because I'd love to have you on board. And that's all, both are free. And both will really help me out, so thank you in advance for that. Now, today's topic, like I said, is all about getting into my dream university, which, in case you didn't know, I've written a whole book about called Getting Into My Dream University, A Guide on How You Can Do the Same. Head to frenchiebychelseaelizabeth.com/shop if you'd like to learn more. I sell this book as a hard copy book like this, and also as an ebook, and it documents the process of me going from high school to the university of my dreams. I share my study tips. I give you practical life advice on how to achieve any goal that you have. So check this out. But today we're going to take some of the concepts that I talk about in this book and break them down. Let's go. You might be a high school student wondering, how do I get into the University of Melbourne? And I get so many questions sent to me about this topic in particular, so I really want to delve into it. And the first step to actually getting into the university of your dreams is to decide that that's what you want. So have that goal in mind, and you really have to commit to the goal. It's not enough to say, oh yeah, maybe after high school I'll go to the University of Melbourne or RMIT or Monash University. I don't know, I think that sounds good. No, that is not going to help you achieve your goal. Like, you need to decide on a goal first and foremost. And I know that that's actually the trickiest part, is deciding, what do I want to do? And that's where it's really important to go to open days. And obviously this year that might change a bit, but still, you know, familiarize yourself with the universities that you have in mind. Go on their websites, talk to students who have been there before, ask me questions about the University of Melbourne that, you know, you need to know about that you can't get from a website. Talk to their student support teams and, you know, future student teams. They have teams dedicated to helping people like you who are searching for universities decide on what they want. So ask them as many questions as you have until you can really get clear on which university you want to go to or what's next. You know, you don't have to go to university, and I talk about that in my book. It's okay if university isn't for you. That's fine. Like, just have some kind of goal in mind of what's next for you after high school. But, you know, this video is kind of geared towards students who are thinking about university, like the University of Melbourne, and are thinking, how do I get in? So step one, decide. Decide that that's what you want. Once you have your goal, you've decided that you want to go to the University of Melbourne, the next step is all about mindset, and that is believing that it's possible. And this is where the hard work comes in, because, you know, often we lack that self-confidence and we have these negative thoughts like, I'll never get into the University of Melbourne, the admission score is too high, you know, I just don't have the brains to get in, but I really want to go, but it's just, I don't think I can do it. And if you talk to yourself like that, well, guess what? You're going to be holding yourself back. You need to change those thoughts and really believe that it's possible. You need to feel deep within your soul that you are already there. You're at the University of Melbourne. It's gonna happen. Like, there's no other option. It's just gonna happen. You need to believe it. You need to feel it. These are the basic principles of the law of attraction, and they work because I've used these techniques before. You know, when I was in high school, I had no idea how I would go to the University of Melbourne. I didn't have the grades, you know, I didn't have those opportunities, but I thought, I'm just gonna go there. I believe it's gonna happen. I know it's going to happen. So that's step two, believe in yourself and just know that it's going to happen. Step three is all about taking action. So you've decided on your goal, you believe in your goal, it's everything you think about, you're constantly visualizing yourself, you know, in the future, going to the University of Melbourne, studying there, you've got that belief and that positive mindset, it's now time to take action. And you know, this I guess is where you really have to keep reminding yourself of your goal, because taking action isn't easy. You know, it takes a lot of hard work, blood, sweat, and tears. I know because I've been there. This is where you have to create your study plan. You know, you might want to take advantage of extra time that you have in your day for study, more study. Just do what you can to boost your grades and to just give, you know, your final years of high school 110%. You know, book in to see your teachers after class. Ask them questions. Ask them to have a look at your English essays, to read over your work, to give you feedback and to let you know what you should be doing more of. Just use your resources, whatever you have. If you can, maybe hire a private tutor to help you with your subjects that maybe you need a bit more help with. Just do what you can within your resource, you know, kind of support group to boost your grades and to just keep working really hard. Honestly, the few years that you do have to spend working tirelessly, it does pay off. I know it because when I was in year 11 and 12, I went from getting average grades in year 11, which is the second last year of high school, I went from getting average grades in English, especially English, to getting really top grades of 90 plus. And the way I did that was actually writing a practice essay every single day. I know, it was crazy. I was so dedicated. I would spend my lunch times in the library. I would go to the library after school and spend hours there studying. I did not stop. So I really think that if, you know that you have that goal and you believe that it's going to happen, this is where you have to keep reminding yourself of the goal, of all the benefits of the goal. Like for me, I was, you know, constantly thinking, okay, my life is going to be amazing when I'm at the University of Melbourne. I have to put in this hard work now so that I can reach that goal. That's what you need to do. You can do it, but this is where the hard work comes in. Study, study, study. Step four is very relevant to the situation that we're in at the moment, and that is to adapt. Now, you never know what life will throw in your way along the way when you're trying to achieve your goals. Sometimes there are hurdles, there are obstacles, and they can be really difficult. They can set you back, but this is where you need to adapt and be smart. So for me, when I was in year 12, which is the final year of high school, I had a really traumatic experience that I share in my book. And, you know, to sum it up, basically I was learning to drive on the freeway, and I had my mum next to me in the front passenger seat and my grandmother in the back passenger seat. I was driving along the freeway 100 kilometers an hour. I looked in the rearview mirror and I saw my grandmother was in the back seat of the car, unconscious, and she was having a heart attack. I didn't know it was a heart attack at the time, but it was so confronting. She nearly died in the car, and I was still learning to drive. You know, I had to pull over and we had to call an ambulance, and seeing her unconscious and so sick, it was really hard. And it, you know, even thinking back at it now, I think, I don't know how I did it. You know, it was a really tough year for me because it was quite traumatic, and these things happen. Life happens. You know, luckily she was okay. I talk about that in the book, but you know, these kinds of things stick with you. They create stress, and my grandmother was in hospital for the rest of the year, basically. So I didn't have my afternoons and my evenings to study at home anymore. I was spending them at the hospital. What did I do? I brought my study to the hospital. I would write practice essays, I would complete practice exams while we sat in the hospital room. And you know, you just have to adapt, because sometimes, you know, life is more important, and spending time with your family, if you're going through, you know, a family illness, it's more important to be there, but you can still study, you can still adapt to the situation, I promise you. And the same goes with the current situation, the pandemic that we're all in. Use this time to your advantage. See how you can use this extra time at home to study and to better yourself. So step four is all about adapting. The fifth and final step is to stop making excuses and stop thinking that your plan B is going to save you. And what I mean by this is that I speak to a lot of people, and I used to tutor high school students, so I know that a lot of people always have a plan B. You know, I've had plan Bs in my life before, and it's great to have them because if things don't work out, you have a backup option. But stop thinking that that's going to save you from working really hard. I want you to be stubborn with your goals. Think that, you know, getting into the University of Melbourne is your only option, because the more you think like that, the more healthy pressure you'll put on yourself to make it happen. You will figure it out along the way. Like, you will just want to work hard. You'll want to see what other options there are to getting from point A to B. You know, maybe there are scholarships that might help you, and maybe your school's underrepresented and you can apply for special consideration or get into the University of Melbourne with a lower ATAR score than you needed. You know, there are so many different ways of getting from point A to B. And if you're stubborn and you say, no, I'm getting into the University of Melbourne, there is no other option, then you will make it happen. I've seen it before. I did it myself. I was so stubborn. You know, if you ask anyone who knew me back in year 12, I was telling them I was going to the University of Melbourne. I don't care how, I will get there. And, you know, I even thought that, okay, worst case scenario, if I don't get in straight away, I'll reapply and see if I can get in again. I will go to another university and see if I can transfer into the University of Melbourne. I was creating all of these, you know, other ways for me to get from high school to university, to the University of Melbourne especially. I was, you know, coming up with so many different creative pathways because that's what I wanted. So I want you to be stubborn, because if that's your dream, you deserve it and you are worthy of that dream. Don't let anybody tell you that, you know, you're dreaming too big. I've had that happen to me. You know, people have told me, you might want to think about having, you know, a different option or going to a different university, or, you know, even in other areas of life, people try and make you take a different route when, no, you want to go a certain pathway, you do that. Like, you do you, you stick to your truth because you deserve it. I really hope that that helped you today, guys. Don't forget that you can purchase a copy of my book at FrenchieByChelseaElizabeth.com/shop. I would love to hear your thoughts on this video. Let me know if you're interested in studying at the University of Melbourne. If so, what are you planning on studying? Let's talk in the comments below. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Click that subscribe button. Come and join the Frenchie fam, because I'd love to have you on board. And I'll see you very soon. Have a great day. Bye.